What's going on, fam? This is KR Jones of the Off the Strength podcast, and I am here to tell you to like, listen, subscribe, and if you're feeling freaky, visit offthestrength.com. That's where you can go and get more information on us. That's where we can link, we can build, we can connect, and let's make this thing work.
I remember my very first job inside of New York City happening in the basement of this very floor plant right here.
Of course, man. When you were a sandwich artist.
When I was just but a young sandwich artist.
A budding sandwich artist.
I was armed with a scoring knife, some hope, dreams, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed is what I'm trying to tell you. And literally, I've been all throughout this building in my lifetime. So to now come back inside here at this stage, I'm feeling pretty good. I feel like we're not quite at the top of the rock, but we ain't too far from it either, man. It's only a matter of time, bro.
Put the rock in the air.
You better know it's time for the rock to be back in the building, bro.
Rockefeller, you know what this is. We're giving y'all 5 seconds to put your drink down and report to the dance floor immediately. All the buses, we giving y'all 5 seconds to get close to an exit. It's about to get real ugly in here. 5 seconds is up. Let's go. Throw the hands up. Throw the hands up. Mac, you know how Mac come through on a club tip. Everybody real deep.
What's good, everybody? What's good? Welcome back to yet another episode of Off the Strength, where we're giving you the inside look into all things wellness culture. I'm a trainer called Tony, and of course, with me, I got a gentleman of extraordinary league.
KR Jones is in the building.
That's right, folks. We are back. And ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, listeners of all type from near and far, you are now in store for a treat because it's the return of the variety show. That's where we give you our best foot forward. So hopefully you take your best foot forward. You do that two-step, that tango, whatever it is you need to do to make it on through the week with the best goddamn wellness information possible. Brother Jones.
What's the word?
How you feeling, man?
I am feeling esteemed.
Okay.
I am feeling pretty, what was the word again we used before? I'm trying to get my words together.
You're digging in the bag.
To describe this moment here, you know, the bliss.
Okay.
If you will.
It's a monumentous occasion.
Tell them why, Tony.
We got to let people know that we are touching back down and you are hearing us now live and direct in a new location, Brother Jones.
A secret location?
It's not quite a secret. I mean, it's literally a storefront.
We're open.
We are open. They're ready for business. We are right inside the heart of the rock, baby. What's going on? We are here recording at Newsstand Studios in Rockefeller Center. Feeling pretty good about that. How you feeling, man?
I'm feeling like I am on the street level.
Yeah.
And the visibility is high.
It is.
And it's making me, you know, feel like I arrived, if you will.
Hell yeah, man. I'm getting my Savannah Guthrie on right now. You know what I mean?
I think it's only right that I hold down the Michael Strahan,
okay,
if you will, the daytime TV.
Daytime TV.
Shout out to all the Gap Tooth people out there. You know
I feel
what I'm it. Because that's the lane that I have to play.
That's what you occupy.
That's what the good Lord gave me, so I got to play it.
Shine on, my man. Yep. Shine on.
Shining bright like a diamond.
Man, you know what's really trippy about this, Kyle? I said this the first time that we came in, but I don't know if our good listeners got a chance to hear this, man. I remember my very first job inside of New York City happening in the basement of this very floor plant right here.
Of course, when you were a sandwich artist.
When I was just but a young sandwich artist.
A budding sandwich artist.
I was armed with a scoring knife, some hope, dreams, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed is what I'm trying to tell you.
You know, prices for take a dive? No, I mean, wait, no, it was a $5 foot long.
$5 foot long.
I'm getting my slogans mixed up.
Yeah, man, it was a $5 foot long, and the guy that we got out of the box was still around, but nonetheless, it was a very, you know, surreal situation to come back inside here, and literally, I've been all throughout this building in my lifetime, so to now come back inside here at this stage, I'm feeling pretty good. I feel like we're not quite at the top of the rock, but we ain't too far from it either, man. It's only a matter of time, bro.
Put the rock in the air.
You better know it's time for the rock to be back in the building, bro.
Understood. Now, if we're going into, you know, quick anecdotes about Rock Center.
What's good?
All I have is that one time that I was on SNL. Well, I wasn't on SNL.
I was about to say, wait a second.
But I was in the building.
You went to SNL.
I went to SNL.
There we go.
Adele was there.
That's a different story.
It was a fun time. It was a jolly old time.
Yeah, okay.
I wasn't a guest. Not yet, but one day.
One day. You would be rolling in the deep, too. You'd be right on that side.
Just hopefully that Kenan Thompson will still be there, because if he ain't there, I ain't going.
You're not
going
to make it work, man.
That's it. That's all I got.
I can't wait to invite the good listeners to stand outside and really cause some, you know, real, I say, Beatles-level pandemonium. Is what I want to see outside this window, Brother Jones.
That sounds a bit aggressive.
That's what I want. We want to restore the feeling inside of New York City.
You can want that for you and you only? I don't know if I necessarily need that.
I want them to be cheering about the Off the Strength movement, Kyle.
Speaking of cheering.
Speaking of which.
How was your week, brother?
It was pretty damn good, man. I was doing some cheering on my side. Shout out to the brother Kerry. Kerry pulled me out to the Roots show yesterday, man, and it was a great time outside, bro. Got to see the 215 all the way live. Actually, the brothers who's also sharing this building over here.
This is true.
You know, the Roots playing for Jimmy Fallon on the back end over here. We're going to get them on the show one day, hopeful. That's what we push
for. Oh, most definitely.
One day, hopeful. That's what we're doing.
That's the nighttime TV. That's the off and the off the strength.
We're going to get with it.
When the off is on.
Their people are contacting our people is really what's happening.
Flip the switch.
But until then, they was doing a pretty damn good performance in the band shell at the park. So shout out to them for doing that.
Oh, much love.
That was a big ticket item on the week, man. How was yours?
Man, my week was definitely productive, off to a good start. You know, now that I got this stretching class that's happening every Tuesday,
I'm
you can
saying,
find your boy.
You got to let them know how they could roll up and roll out.
Man, so I've partnered with the good folks over at Bread and Butter.
Okay.
And, you know, that's the necessity. That's what you need.
Got to get your bread
and butter. That's the name of the place, of the establishment. You know it's the place you need to be.
Exactly.
But Tuesday nights from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m., I'm going to be hosting a nice little roll up and roll out.
Uh-huh.
Now, for the people out there that don't stretch.
Yes.
This where you need to be.
Okay.
And now for the people out there that like to roll up, you know, a little, you know where I'm going with this.
CBD.
Know? Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
The herbal,
yeah,
if you will. The
relaxation.
The flowers.
I hear you.
For the people that like the floral arrangements.
A nice bouquet.
A nice bouquet.
I see you.
We can do that in stretch.
Trees
all in
and
the
all
same
that.
Space. So that, I've been blessed with a couple more clients that I picked up on the roster. So it's just been a good week, man. A lot of good new energy that I've been helping people with this movement.
Man, you had new energy coming in. You had all different types of classes that are coming up, and people can now look forward to on a weekly basis touching down and rolling up with Brother Jones.
They get to see this mug at least once a week.
Man, we on the street level. We man to the people, not above, simply equal. I'm feeling pretty good, man.
Oh, you got bars now.
I'm ready for it, man. I told you, top of the rock, I'm back in the charts, man. I'm here for it. And since I'm here for it, I really wish that we could get outside in these streets and answer their questions directly, but we got to change gears and move on into this next segment, man. It's time for that ATP, brother. You know what I'm talking about?
You mean ask the professionals.
That's what time it is. Next set. Let's get into it.
Sometimes I think that the people in this institution and in the White House are really losing contact and not knowing what's going on with the American people. In case you don't know,
man, so now, coming into this side and on this week, Brother Jones, did you get any questions coming down your way, my man?
I did, actually.
Okay, let's hear what the professionals are talking about.
The question that came in was, do you have any tips to shift my mindset from viewing workouts as a punishment to instead viewing a workout as a celebration of what my body can do?
Huh. Viewing workout as a reward instead of a punishment inside here.
In short, yes.
In short, yeah. You should never really do anything as a punitive act. I don't think so, man. That's not really what life's about in my book. You know what I mean? Anything that you vehemently dislike to that level is probably not the thing that you should do. But there is a wide bounty and array of movement that you can invest in. So maybe I would say, before we go into too deep as to what you need to do specifically, maybe you just need to visit a little bit more stuff in terms of what exercise can be inside your aperture. You know, open up your lens, if you will. Just because it's exercise doesn't mean it has to be structured and it has to look like a certain thing. Like, I remember when I was coming up, man, Gold's Gym days, exercise was Arnold Schwarzenegger's Bible. All right, I'm going to do chest on Monday.
I'm going to do the Arnold press.
Arnold press. You know, we got to get in here back on Tuesday. Then I'm gonna double up arms on Wednesday, maybe sneak in a leg day, but really go right back to chest on Thursday.
I'll be back.
And then just moving forward, right? That had a wave. And then we saw, you know, after that, we saw the Group X wave coming in and out, you know? Then we saw a little bit of the CrossFit wave coming back and forth. And there's a lot of tribes out there that people might see and be like, that's the only definition of what fitness is. But we celebrate wellness and wellness culture. So it could be something that might be a little bit more of a dance if you like to dance. It could be something that looks a little bit more like my brother over here who's talking to you about the supreme nature and understanding how you move more fluidly. Maybe you're rolling out. Maybe you're doing yoga. Maybe you just need to try different things and you'll find that thing that makes it feel a little less like punishment, a little bit more like you're enriching yourself.
I mean, that sounded lovely. I'm not
even, now.
I can't even see where I would go, but I think more along the lines of that mindset has to come to the forefront. So just changing the mindset of it's not going to be a punishment. It's going to be that reward. It's going to be that celebration. And think about, you know, I was telling a client of mine earlier today, like people ask me why I ride my bike so much, because I remember the day when I couldn't do a full revolution on the bike, on the pedals. I remember that day when it was a struggle to be able to do that. So that's why I take pride in being able to move. And to your point earlier, man, if there's something that you don't like, you have to widen that lens of things that you do and discover whether it's dance, whether it is a yoga, whether it is, you know, I've seen people play handball in New York. Have you?
Everything, man.
Tennis. There's so many different ways to move, to sweat, to burn calories, to do something that you enjoy. And that is what is going to allow you to open up that wellness lens.
Yeah, man. And just to put my last thought on that side, Kyle, you know, being in the position that I'm in right now, specifically, where my movement is impaired, and I had the ability, but now I don't quite have the same type of ability. I will say any day that you can move unimpaired and uninhibited is a day that you should celebrate regardless of the fact. If you can go out for a walk, take that walk. If you can take the stairs instead of the elevator, do that one time. You know, park a little further away. You know, do whatever it is you can to make that investment. It's not a punishment. It's an investment in your life strategy. I promise you, every step you walk in the direction of that investment is going to be exponentially better at the tail end for whatever it is you need to do in that day. If you have the ability, in my book, you have the obligation to reward yourself with the gift of movement. That's going to be it on my side, bro.
That was a triple word score.
I'm here, man.
Of all the Off the Strength episodes that we have right there. So I want to shout out TB Elite.
Hell yeah.
And just tell people that you got to find those opportunities to move.
OTMs.
OTMs.
From OTS.
From OTS.
You get me. OPP sometimes.
Hey.
You now, know me.
I don't know nothing about that. You're talking about other people's property, right?
No. Push-ups. We're taking them.
Other people's push-ups?
Yeah, we're going to take those.
There you go. Other people's podcasts.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what we was
doing. Only this podcast.
Only this one.
There we go.
Here on out.
It's a family show.
Yes.
Let's keep it that way.
Yes, man. You know, I'm sorry, Kyle. I got a little carried away, man. I was getting lost inside the good. You know, we transitioned into the bad, and then you know it also comes into the ugly because it's time. It's time, my friend, once again, for that rip from the headlines. And man, oh man, Brother Jones, I have to celebrate some good friends. Friends of the show.
Okay.
Friends that have been on the show, I don't know if you got a chance to see, but the largest ever campaign pushed out by one, you know, the good Canadians up north.
Okay.
You know, them Lulu people.
Yeah, I know who you're talking about.
The Science of Feel and all the emotions around Feel. They have a giant campaign going on where right now I could walk down this very block and I could see a giant billboard of some friends that we know, like the homie Minaj Diaz, my man.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
My relationship's changing to that word because I now know that I have the ability to change the narrative around what wellness really means. You know, wellness should be accessible to everyone.
Buddha and Balenciaga?
Buddha and Balenciaga is what I'm trying to tell you.
Okay, okay.
Here. Just slightly underneath the organic thuggery, you know what I mean?
Small notch.
It's not too far under, yeah. But I was happy to see Brother Minaj all over in an international campaign. And it wasn't just the Brother Minaj. I also saw Deja Riley was inside a part of this international campaign.
Well, I'm Deja Riley, is a door check. Hello, beautiful people!
So I gotta land the homies being on big billboards all over the world in campaigns. That's gonna land into the good for me this week, man. How do you feel about seeing people that we keep seeming to curate and the people that we just rock with going up, literally glowing up in different types of ways, man. What's your thoughts on that?
It's two thoughts right there.
Let's hear it.
First thought is, we are for sure the headhunters, if you will, or talent scouts. Off the Shrimp, pretty much, is what it really is.
Tastemakers.
Like, we talk to the folks, and next thing you know, you next in the upper echelon kind
of
atmosphere, if you will.
Tapped in.
That's first. Second, I mean, if they on Off the Shrimp, it's only right that we have to continue to amplify these voices.
Keep
so
lifting.
I can only celebrate Deja. Shout out to her. Shout out to Minaj. You know, that's the homie right there.
Hell yeah, man. And we haven't had Deja on just yet, but I can't wait to get her on soon. Unfortunately, we had to hit a couple of those reschedules, you know, when I had a little bit of incident.
Yeah, a little bump.
A little, you know, swerve in the road, so to speak. But we back in here. We're going to get that back on that other side, man. But they are definitely landing in the good. So if they landed in the good.
Take us to the bad.
I don't actually have a bad this week. I do have something that is even more gooder.
Wait. We're not going to speed past that. You put an extra ER on gooder. That's the same as mo better.
Mo better and gooder. They're in the same book.
Okay. let's just hear this, man.
I was happy to see this week an announcement from Health Club Management that David Beckham was named the official ambassador for F45, those clubs that's popping up all over the world right now.
Are you talking about DB?
DB, man.
Nah, you know that's the homie, man.
Bending it like Beckham. He's coming back around, and this time he's trying to get everybody fit, man. I had to give him some props for that because, again, this F45 is on the move. They went public 2 weeks ago, if you remember our last talk.
They got that IPO out.
IPO came out, and now they're putting Beckham in the front, man. They look like a power move to me. This is why I had to pay attention to what was going on because I know we're going to continue to see celebrities adopting our culture, and our culture is going to keep expanding, my man. I already knew what the roadway ahead was going to look like, but now I'm seeing it pop up even more. How you feeling again about now the big homies coming around?
I mean, I can only celebrate that. Has there ever been another group fitness studio that has had that same type of lane as the F45? I can think of like New York specific places, but not someone that has come out of the country to.
I'll say this much about them. So there's a couple that are in their genre. And in the liking of them, I'd say they're not too far off of a Barry's or too far off of an Orange Theory. But their franchise model specifically, what makes them unique, is something that started off in Australia. And I even know somebody who split from that original company. Shout out to everybody who was at Sessions. I think you might have been there over in Williamsburg a little while ago.
Yeah.
So I do know a couple of the founders. I do know some people that were starting off there pretty early on. I like it because they are truly strength and conditioning focused. And it's that at the forefront that gets you closer to the results and the type of impact that you want. The other places might be hard for the sake of hard or just flashy for the sake of flashy, but they actually are delivering a pretty solid
product. They're about that work.
Can't knock that.
Now, the only thing that I will knock about F45 is that they have a playlist. It's like an F45 playlist that you can't change. So I'm just go ahead and tell them right there. Tell them right now.
Let's look at them.
You need K.R. Jones on your playlist.
Put them in the
first
box.
And foremost, because the playlist y'all have is mediocre at best.
Soggy.
It's real level mid. It's not really slapping the way it should.
Nah.
So F45 people, I know y'all listening because it's off the strength.
You gotta be.
You gotta holler at your boy for the playlist.
They need the sauce, you saying?
They need the sauce.
We gotta put them in the sauce, my man.
It sounds pretty ugly.
It was an ugly situation. Now,
without the sauce.
Listen, man, if we were celebrating the homies from the UK in the first act,
okay.
Second act is where I got to put a line and draw that down in the sand, my man. And again, it's not necessarily ugly business, but okay, they are starting to roll out some incentives to get people to be more active inside of the UK, right? And we talked about this before, but now they have made a proclamation, Kyle. The United Kingdom is trying to be the healthiest place on Earth by 2023. I'm offended by this because we're in the heart of New York City. We can't miss a fitness space between block to block over here. There's probably at least six around where we are right now at this moment in time. How, if the home of Off the Strength is inside right now, we right inside the rock right now, you know what I mean? If we over here, we can't be letting the UK take over. It's kind of like we lost the World Cup of Fitness right now. Kyle, I can't let this happen on my watch, man.
It's beef in it.
We got to go over there, fix up, look sharp, man. We can't let them have this. We got to defend our territory. We must protect this house is what I'm trying to tell you, Jones.
It's about the peas, fam.
We got to get them.
The peas, the pounds.
We can't let them get off this. You know, we got to box somebody over there, man. I don't like everybody else trying to take what we created and now trying to really corner the market and say that they're going to be the best in the world.
It's a big man thing.
Yeah, man. So I have to say right here, right now, that that's not going to happen on our watch, because we're going to try to electrify the people outside on these streets, at least, to get moving too. So I see them doing something good. I just want to make sure that we keep that up too. You got any thoughts about how we can maybe start to activate this coalition of the willing stateside?
I mean, I think it comes from us.
It has to be.
I think the push comes from this, and it comes from the people listening to this and feeling like they got to move. Because I'm going to be damned if I'm going to let some dude over across the pond.
They can't have it.
Try to come over here.
Doing laps around the English Channel.
Exactly. You've seen the Olympics. I ain't got to talk about the track.
Big medals.
You've seen what we was doing.
That's what we trying to come back with, man. So I'm not going to let that go out like that, brother. That's why that landed in the bag. But that's going to be it from this week's Rip from the Headlines, man.
All right. Feel like after we just ripped the headlines
apart,
you know what you gotta do after that.
Gotta pick them back up.
You gotta raise the bar.
Lift them up, bro. Let me hear where this raising the bar is taking us this week.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, listeners of all type from the info,
mm-hmm.
You are now in store for Raising the Bar segment.
Let's get it to them.
Now, you know me, I got a little more free time these days, so I take that time to consume the content that I want to consume, if you will.
Find some time and do some things.
You know, to fight that boredom.
I see you.
You know, shout out to Thomas.
Shout out.
So, naturally, you know, I was on, you know, Netflix, if you will, and I saw something that popped up. It was Malice in the Palace.
Malice in the Palace. Brother, remind the good listeners of what that is.
I was going to ask you if you remembered, you know what I'm saying?
I do remember.
Because I think your picture might be a little more vivid than mine at this time. So when I say Malice in the Palace, what do you think of, Brother Tone?
I remember that time that everybody in the NBA found out that little piece of velvet that might be between...
You mean the movie extension?
The little movie extension.
That thin layer that separates you from...
and primetime action on the basketball court can easily be eradicated... if you overcross that line. Now, that was when Jermaine O'Neal, Ron Artest. Stack Five was coming right back inside there, and they put hands on fans. That's pretty much what the big takeaway was from that.
Hands on fans.
Hands on fans.
It's definitely a great alliteration, if you will, or, you know, a nice rhyme scheme, so to speak. So I say all this to say that when I remember it, I just remember the main takeaway again was taking back to 2004. We had Detroit Pistons versus Indiana Pacers. A brawl breaks out. It goes into the fans, as you said. And I just remember the media. The media was tearing the basketball players apart,
mm-hmm.
right? Every day. You know, they got these thugs on TV, and that's the word they kept using.
Thug.
What's thug? Here we are, what, how many years later? 15, 17, you do the math,
mm-hmm.
one might have a brand called Organic Thug.
The Thugs.
Right?
They're back.
The highest under God, if
the
you will.
The highest under God. That's right? The real acronym for Thug.
So as I'm sitting and watching this documentary and I'm looking at the media pick these people apart, you know what they were blaming it on? They were blaming it on hip-hop culture.
Damn it!
They were like, these gangster wannabes and the hip-hop culture, they were throwing the dress code around. This is why we need a dress code, and this is why they can't... Blah, blah, blah. So many different things. So it got my mind spinning, naturally. Because now you're taking this thug, and you're taking this hip-hop, which are, you know, some might say synonymous, some might say they're two different elements, right? But I also recall that on about 2 days ago, August 11th was the anniversary of this thing we call hip-hop, right? And that was started in 1973. So hip-hop is relatively young, about 48. That's a young man right there, or woman, however you want to identify.
Mm-hmm.
But nonetheless, I'm looking at the correlation between the two. And I'm like, so you got these so-called thugs that were driven by hip-hop culture. Not the disrespect of somebody that threw a cup on you. When you really unpack what hip-hop culture is as a whole, it comes from that African diaspora, right?
Mm-hmm.
You think of things like storytelling. I think of things like call and response. I think of dancing to music, right? These are things that were ingrained in us. So as I'm looking at the media attack these people, blaming it through the lens on hip hop, I can only think, but wow, like this is something that we've always done, right? And the interesting takeaway when Jermaine O'Neal was talking was like, yo, people fight in hockey all the time, but y'all never called them thugs,
mm-hmm.
right? You've never took the music that they listen to and unpacked that. Like, You ever listen to heavy metal?
Hell yeah.
You ever listen to somebody scream at the top of their lungs into a microphone?
Explicitly when I'm angry.
Right?
It makes sense.
That seems way more aggressive than what hip-hop would be when I think about Illmatic, right? Or I think about any of those other classic albums that don't fall under the thug-like mentality, so to speak.
Mm-hmm.
So as I'm unpacking all of these different things, I'm getting to thinking about the tattoo culture, the dress code because of AI and the jerseys, and rappers want to be ball players want to be rappers, all these things. But at the end of the day, there wouldn't be a sport if it wasn't for us,
mm-hmm.
right? There wouldn't be anything to cover if it wasn't for these athletes. You can't celebrate someone for what they do on the court, but then not recognize where they came from. When you think about a Ron Artest, you know where he came from. He was from Queens. He was from Queensbridge. You think about a Jermaine O'Neal. He came from down south. We talked about growing up with the Confederate flag hanging up in his school. You think about Stack 5, where he lives or where he comes from. I can't really think right now, but you think about the George Floyd comparison that Steven Jackson had. These three people were pivotal points to what we know as hip-hop culture, to what we know as elite players in basketball, yet the media picked these people apart.
You know, they realistically were young. Ron
Artest was 23 years old.
Yeah, yeah.
They kept talking about the money that they gave them and how they responded to it. You give that average 23-year-old right now a contract well into the millions and see how they act. See what happens when you put a camera in front of them. This segment of Raising the Bar today was to analyze again how the media portrays people, how they portray these athletes, the angles that they take in these stories, and understanding you got to see it from all angles. When they showed the footage, they had cameras from all angles. So where they were able to identify the dude who threw the beer and started it, like the dude who came on the floor past that extension that you talked about, all the things happened, and it was just like, wow, this is, 17 years later. So I found that to be very interesting. My bar was raised knowing that out of all of them, Jermaine O'Neal was the only one that didn't get a championship.
Yeah.
And that was only because Ron Artest left.
Yeah.
Steven Jackson eventually got a championship. Ron Artest got that championship with Kobe. Rest in peace to Kobe with the Lakers. But, that was a turning point in his career. Now he's at a point where he's established and he could talk about that. Although they probably don't want to talk about it after this documentary. But I just thought that was the interesting part to my week this week.
So it was growth-centric, and seeing that growth, seeing the possibility that comes across with that, that's fantastic, man. I do want to go through that and dive into a couple things that came up, if I can reflect back to you, Brother Jones.
Lay it on me.
Immediately after the suspension started getting doled out and you saw the NBA starting to constrict a little bit, first thing they're doing, making you change the uniforms or the uniform requirement, right? Where you had to go from, okay, you can't just come in with the ice out, the bust down, and the jerseys. Now you got to come in wearing the suits, right? Look at how that changed over the years, where you got Russell Westbrook, shout out to him over there, but now homie would pull up looking like somebody from the Fifth Element.
Most definitely.
He's got a fashion show coming back.
He's quite futuristic in his attire.
All types of craziness. Love to see how you start with constraining something, but then when it does get a chance to express itself, it's going to go even further past what you probably were trying to put a little dampening on before that. Seeing how the NBA is now being more responsive to fans overstepping their boundaries and getting those fans out of there, ejecting people, even getting some people arrested after they have assaulted people like a Russell Westbrook or anybody in that direction. So I'm happy to see that the long arc of time does show consistently some type of evolution that comes across inside that space. So that's what I'm also hopeful to come inside that position and see that, yes, maybe we were labeled for the music, we were labeled for the attire, we were labeled for all the rest of these things that were pejorative, but now it's kind of a global phenomenon. So it's undeniable. You can't put this in a box. You can't make people not be who they are. And now people are getting a chance to be even bigger and brighter in that direction because of these things. So shout out to everybody that you mentioned inside there stepping back into that same light and not feeling like they have to dull themselves to be accepted. I love that.
It's a beautiful thing.
Yeah, man. It makes me hopeful.
Hopeful?
Yeah. You got to be hopeful inside that direction.
I mean, you sure you didn't relax first?
You know what? That's probably the direction that you need to go into. The transition. We slipped on that one, man.
The transition is all good. So I'm going to ask you, Brother Tone, how did you relax this
week? We got to get into that relax responsibly, man. And you know what? This week, Brother Jones, I was really kicking back. and I was starting to get a little bit more into, so I told you, and I mentioned to my man off the mic, I was getting a little bit more into the nootropic side of things, right? Testing out some different stuff, and they're getting me ready.
You're going to have to slow down, all right? Because there's somebody out there that don't know what nootropics means.
If they don't know what nootropics means, I'm going to tell you to go back in the archives of the Off the Strength podcast, because we've had this conversation many times.
Multiple times.
And I'm going to reference the Adam...
This is for the layperson.
The layperson.
That's not in their vocab.
Listen, we got a lot of episodes. I'm trying to get them to go to the back catalog.
You heard it here.
Go back and listen to the Adam Greenfield episode. You will find out everything you need to know from beginning, middle, to end about how to dip your toe into that space. That was only a quick abridged moment because coming off of my stimulants, I needed something to get a little bit more relaxing, right? So I have some CBD infusions inside there with a little bit of honey that was quite splendid, my man.
Really?
Yes. I ain't dropping a name yet because I want to see if they can come with a check. So as soon as I figure that out, y'all hear about that one.
As soon as they cut the check, you're going to holler at
them. CTC before you see me, baby. That's really how we got to get it down.
Understood. Well, for me this week, man, so I have taken this deep dive into The Wire.
Okay.
The HBO documentary series, whatever you want to call it, solely because I never watched it. And being as though that I'm from Baltimore, I was like, all right, now it's time. I got this free time on my hands. Let me go back, do this deep dive. And it is truly a timepiece. Mm. Solely because it was how many years ago? 2002. It's been some time. So to go back and to see payphones, to see
beepers.
Beepers.
Yeah.
typewriters. Chevrolet Cavaliers, fam. I ain't seen a Cavalier in so long. I remember my mom's had the two-door one back in the day.
Nice.
But to see these type of things and to see this, like, people that I know, that I grew up with on the show as, like, extras and small roles. But it's like, fam, I know him. He used to live down the block from me. So I've deep dived into that. And the writing is really what I think is the beauty in it, just because I can see how funny it is and the satire of moments that aren't supposed to be funny. Like, there's a lot of face actors out here. I know we clown Michael B. Jordan for, you know, not having lines and, you know, using a lot of facial expressions. But fam, the facial expressions in The Wire at an all-time high. So I really appreciate that. And that's really how I've been relaxing, man. I got it down to a system. It's about 3 episodes a day. So now I'm in season 3.
Okay.
I got 2 more seasons to go. But, you know, it's keeping me busy.
I like it, man. It's not bringing up any ill feelings as long as you're coming inside there.
Yeah, no. Nothing bad. You know what I'm saying? You know, I'm removed from that life.
There we go.
What you're talking
there
about,
we go.
You
know? There we go.
I don't know nothing about what you're talking
that's
about.
That's exactly what. Listen, less is more on that side, brother. I understand where you're going.
There's plenty of us.
Yes.
So, Brother Tone, man, tell me about something that you hopeful for this
There we
week.
Go. I was getting a little lost in the sauce the last
time,
man.
Now you're here.
Man, you know what? I got a chance to check into a Jemele Hill podcast where she was interviewing Issa Rae.
Okay.
And I heard a little bit about her path, and she was given everything that led up from awkward black girl transitioning into the first season of Insecure. And then how that first season of Insecure didn't necessarily look like it was going to click, but then finally did make it past that critical point to get into the next few seasons of that show. And now they're closing the chapter on that book, and now she's talking about all the other things that she has to go through. And I'm reminded of another back episode of Off the Strength where we think about everything having a season, right? And I got a shout out to Sister Trina out there. Again, if you need to catch the reference, folks, we got a library that I'm happy to point you in the right directions
for. Just go back and dig in them crates.
We'll make sure that we link those episodes in this place. But essentially, everything has a season. And when you're in that season of transition, you have to be able to look forward to not just the things that you are going to get to do, but also being okay with leaving some things behind in order to make that next transition. So somewhere in that interview that she was giving, Kyle, I got a chance to hear the aspiration of somebody who is already celebrated and heralded as a top-level creative in her field, thinking about how far they can push that bar a little bit further down the line. And from my position right now, gave me a little bit more hope inside of that direction where it's kind of like, okay, I'm not where I want to be, but if the best creators out there are not quite where they want to be just yet, but they recognize their season of change and how they're going to start to keep that going forward, I need to adopt some of that energy and make sure I carry that into my next week.
Understood. I mean, that was a lot. Shout out to Jemele. Shout out to Issa Rae. You know, she snuck and got married, which I can only appreciate somebody. The sneaking married.
That's a pretty good one to do.
That's what I'm saying. And to have that level of celebrity and to pull that one off, you got to applaud that when you see it.
I support it.
Now, for me being hopeful this week, again, I'm going to have to harken back.
Okay.
to this versus between the Lox and Dipset.
Okay, okay.
Once again, I'm coming right back to it.
Let's hear it.
And the reason I come back to it and the reason it makes me hopeful is because people are finally coming around to how good of an artist an MC Jadakiss was. Mm-hmm. And the work that not only him, but Styles P and Sheik Louch put in. You know, the championship belt, so to speak.
Like, the championship belt.
The champ is here.
That's the only belt that I will acknowledge that Jadakiss should be wearing is the championship belt. Every other belt is a falsy belt.
We're not going back to you and what did you call it? The melt belt?
He was wearing a melt belt.
We're not going to talk about that.
A straight up waist trainer. That's right. That's what was happening. We do not condone that.
Again, that's between you and Jadakiss. I ain't got nothing to do with this, right? Now, I say that I've seen the reaction. You know how people react. People throw videos up. And it's like a whole new generation has been introduced to the Lox music. Mm-hmm. And being as though that I feel like we're going to get into a music conversation at some point, sooner than later, I'm just happy and hopeful to see that real hip-hop, in my sense, and what I've grown up to know, is actually being portrayed and perpetuated to the youth who had no idea it ever existed. And that is what got me hopeful.
Man.
Right there.
I like it, man. The feeling of the city is alive and well. We're coming in with that musicality.
New York is outside.
Back in here.
You know what I mean?
Not going in.
Exactly.
Keeping it moving, man. I appreciate that, Brother Jones. Anything else you want to put on that?
Nah, man. That's all I got for the people this week, man.
That's all that's going
to
be, man.
You know, anything else, they're going to have to pay for that.
Hey, man. We ready to switch up gears anyway. Get some of these other youthful spirits inside the situation. So that's going to be it from this week's episode of Off the Strength. I'm a trainer called Tony.
KR Jones.
Peace and much love to y'all. Until next time, we'll see you soon. What's good, everybody? I'm a trainer called Tony, and I am here from the infamous Off the Strength podcast, asking you today, listeners, viewers, wherever you may be, to please like, listen, and subscribe to our podcast. This is how we're going to continue to be able to deliver you the best goddamn wellness information out here. So if you want to keep hearing this and you want us to keep growing, you are a part of this show just as much as anything else. So please go to offthestrength.com. Make sure you check out our blogs. Make sure you check us out on IG. And if you're hearing this voice and you didn't hit that subscribe button, know that Kyle is going to come looking for you.
You got that right.